project takes its title from a sculpture by a Swiss modernist artist called Alberto Giacometti. The title is The Palace at 4 a.m. This work of art has been tremendously influential for generations of artists. It's strange, surreal, drama, and the idea of what happens at dark, just before the sun rises. Just as Delos was a cosmopolitan hub, this exhibition brings together 13 artists from more or less around the globe. They also span 50 years of generations in contemporary art.
I'm attracted to the epics of the old time, Gilgamesh and Homer. These, for me, are the texts that inspire me, that touch me the most. I think my work is an abstracted way of showing something. Even my standing figures, they are abstracted. And it's like poetry. Poetry is an abstract way of writing, because you summarize your feelings in a very short sentence.
Το 1980 έγιναν αυτά τα τέσσερα δειγματολόγια. Είναι το δειγματολόγιο του ξύλου, του χαρτιού, του μέταλλου και του τοίχου. Εκείνη την εποχή, όπως και για πάρα πολλά χρόνια αργότερα και μέχρι τώρα ακόμα, δούλευα πάνω στα στοιχεία του αστικού τοπίου, δηλαδή του τοπίου της πόλης, του τοπίου που ζούμε και περιφερόμαστε και υπάρχουμε.
For the exhibition, The Palace at 4 a.m., I was commissioned by Neon Foundation here in Greece to make two site-specific works of art for the show, which is curated by Iwona, Blazwick and Elina Kountouri. I was truly inspired by a particular aspect of the artifacts on the island, the mosaic of Dionysus, which is in the house of Dionysus on the island. It's really about this collage of ideas and trade and commerce that came to the island, but it's also to show this kind of international cosmopolitan way of life. The work behind me, which is called 6 Months, is probably related more to the style culture of the island, which I was intrigued by, because apart from the statues, most textiles do not survive. So I had to imagine a kind of costume the women and the men would dress, but also the motifs, which I found very beautiful on the island.
I feel like there's always the search of a connection to something spiritual, to be able to call yourself as part of the place, as part of the community. And I like the idea how these plants are created their own communities. So I started to visit forests and gardens and learned about the plants and disguised myself as a metaphor of finding a home.
So the work is an abstract sculptural map. And I was inspired by two female goddesses that were associated with the island of Delos. One was Leto, who was the lover of Zeus, and the other was Isis, who was worshipped as the protectress of seafarers. Also, in a more abstract level, I wanted the work to refer to the, let's say, nature of female power, how this is fragmented in a way, but then finds again its totality through the form of a network.
I decided to work on a sculpture that falls off the roof, or the top, the ceiling. The feet, the hand and the face is based on myself, so it's a kind of a self-portrait, this work. And it has also Janus' head, so there is the face, and on the other side another face, but this is twisted. So I'm playing with this Janus' head image.
So my piece in the exhibition is called In the Palace, and it's an effort to enter inside Giacometti's The Palace at 4 a.m., an effort to enter into this space which is physically constricted, but which invites the imagination. And in place of Giacometti's four enigmatic figures, I've inserted into this large framework for performers who strike poses from early 20th century dance publicity stills. And as such, I'm also imagining my way more fully inside these evocative but flat images.
This is a place of imagination, mythologies, history that brought us here, and that we could find similarities in so many places in East Balkan or in around the world. And it's beautiful to see how in the room here, as the fragments that come from completely different place, which is Kosovo, it seems that they just left the pot, and as birds somehow they became birds and flow in the landscape. As birds that kind of migrate beyond borders and cultures, and they are free to have their own life independently from us and from our human social problems that kind of a lot of times can unify us, but unfortunately sometimes also divide us.
Στη δική μου περίπτωση, το έργο που επελέχθηκε, Πελάζ, προσπαθεί να ακροβατήσει απέναντι στη φόρμα που καθορίζεται από το περιεχόμενό του, όπως και τα αγγεία του μουσείου, που η φόρμα τους καθορίζεται από τις ανάγκες για τις οποίες προορίζονταν, έτσι και η φόρμα, το έργο Πελάζ, προσπαθεί να βρει τις διαστάσεις της μέσα από τις ψυχικές μας διαθέσεις. Αυτό δηλαδή που επιχειρεί να φιλοξενήσει είναι το ψυχισμό μας.
Με την έκθεση αυτή, η σύγχρονη καλλιτεχνική δημιουργία εισβάλλει και σχεδόν χωροκατακτά το μουσείο. Με τον τρόπο αυτό, οι αρχαιότητες αντιπαραβάλλονται με τις σύγχρονες δημιουργίες και ο στόχος μας ήταν, μέσα από αυτή τη διαδικασία, το μουσείο να πάψει για λίγο να είναι ένας περιχαρακωμένος πόλος μνήμης και να μετατραπεί σε ένα δημιουργικό εργαστήρι πολυπολιτισμικής καλλιτεχνικής δημιουργίας.
This exhibition is a manifestation on how art is about encountering other people's language, other people's experiences, other people's view of the world. This collaboration between the private and the public sector is a civic and public necessity. It is the way forward in order for all of us to reach out to a wide range of audiences, to think about our past, link it with the present, and consider the future.